So our testing setup has two things. So this thing is the trailer and that thing is the van. So the purpose of the van is that we are going to sit in the van and we are going to drive. So it also, the van is the driver force here, which gives the speed so that the tire also rotates at the same speed. And also all the engineers will be operating the test from the van. And one more important thing about the van is that it also can store the water. It has the capacity of storing 1500 liters. That is useful for our R117 test. Now let us come here inside. So this is the position where the tire is mounted, and behind the tire is the adapter. So there are this is the adapter. There are different adapters which are made by us. It depends upon what type of rim and what type of tire we are using. Based on that, we have different adapters which we fix into the hub sensor. So if you see that, this thing is a hub sensor. That is a standard F&M hub sensor, and I'll show you the other side of that. In the other side, what you can see, these are the brake pads, and you can also see the brake disc. So this is helpful for the braking of the tire, especially in our R117 test. And I'll also show you this thing. This is called the ballast system. The use of this ballast system is that this ballast system can move along this rail. So by the movement of this ballast system, the tire gets loaded over here. And one more important thing is that we also have a laser sensor over here. This sensor helps us to find what is the ground temperature of the track surface, especially during the test. And there are also something which are important over here. This is the nozzle. This it is from this nozzle the water jet comes out, and it is helpful in the R117 test. So there is a actuator over here. Once the test triggers, automatically that actuator comes down, and it comes to a height of almost this much, and it releases the water.
15 mm.
Yeah,
15 mm. Tell the exact amount. It's okay. Continue.
And this is also an actuator. This is a pneumatic actuator. It is helpful to lift off the tire to 3000 Newton once the test is done. Now let us come to van part. Okay. You have to come. I told you that we have a tank. We have a provision to store the water. That is a tank. It's a tank which can hold water of 1500 liters. And now to pump those water to the nozzle, we also have a DG set which runs through petrol, and this DG set can be controlled through the driver's cabin. Now let's go to the back part of the van. I'll show you. Okay, yeah, there is one more important safety feature. So this is the handbrake for the trailer, and you see this is also a jockey wheel. Whenever you are giving rest to the trailer, you can use this jockey wheel. By rotating it anti-clockwise, the wheel goes down so that the trailer weight is not on this hitch point here. Now this hitch point, if you see, there is a red color wire. This wire is an additional safety feature. In case if your trailer disconnects from the van, automatically this wire gets triggered. When this wire gets triggered, automatically your brakes, the trailer also has brakes, so those brakes get activated and the trailer stops immediately once the connection from the van is gone off. As I already told you that all this trailer testing and controlling will be done from the driver cabinet, but also we can control the trailer from this rear cabinet. So there are, if you see this box has all the electrical circuits that are linked to the trailer system. This is like a kind of CPU for the trailer. And there is one important thing. You can see there are two things over here. Rear control only mode and standard mode, rolling resistance mode. So this, whenever this is on, that means you are able to control the trailer using the rear cabinet. These are all the controls. This is for the vertical load. Once you press this plus, that means the tire is going to load. This means the load is going off the tire. This is for the braking, the amount of brake pressure you wanted to give on the brake disc. And this is for the camber angle, what the tire system has to achieve, slip angle. And this is for the water nozzle, water valve, and load decrease. I said you there is one pneumatic actuator for which lifts the load by 3000 Newton. So this is that option. And one more important thing about this is that whenever you are planning to control the trailer from the driver's cabin,
you should always put it in the off mode. When you put it in the on mode, all these connections from the driver cabinet will be lost. So only this is the, and there is also a e-stop over here. There are completely three e-stops which I forgot to show in the trailer main cabinet. I'll show you later. So this is one of the e-stop which you can use. And by the way, this is the battery. So this is a 24 volt battery which power ups the whole trailer system. And there is also a compressor. This compressor is used to power up your pneumatic and hydraulic fluids which we use in the trailer system. I was talking about the e-stop. So this is the other e-stop. So this e-stop is provided in for that purpose. Whenever you are working inside the trailer and suppose suddenly some of the mechanics has got on, if something is happening, immediately the person who is working can press this so that all the mechanics will get off. And again, by twisting it clockwise, you get it off. Here you can see the fire extinguisher. This is also a safety feature. In case of any fire accident or anything, fire has happening, you can use this fire extinguisher. Now let's go to the driver cabinet. So the trailer is always run by two people. So one of them will be driving the vehicle and one of them will be controlling the trailer. This is the spot where you fix the laptop. You see this wire? This is a LAN cable which connects to the laptop and that is connected to the main CPU box. If you remember, there is that rear control mode. That CPU box is connected via to the laptop via this LAN. These are the controls which are present in the driver cabin that an engineer can control. When you do from 0 to 1, that means all your electronics has got switched on. This is about the trailer. And now, talking about the mechanics of the trailer, if you want your all mechanical parts of the trailer to get active, then you have to press this power button. This is for the electronics and this is for the power mechanics. When I'm talking about power mechanics, it is about loading the tire, giving the slip angle, moving the nozzle up and down, all these functions. You can also see there is a flashing light which we generally switch it on while we are testing. So this is an indication for the people around us that we are under test and so that they can be in some caution. And this is a pump ignition. As I've mentioned, there is a DG set in the back side of this van which is useful for pumping the water. Once you switch it on from 0 to 1 and you press this pump starter, this is like giving power to the DG set, and when you press this, the DG set gets